What's up, everybody? My name is Austin, and today we're going to be taking a look at where one of the biggest busts in NBA history is, Anthony Bennett. But before we get into that, we're going to take a short look at his career to see what events led him to where he is now. Let's get started. Anthony Bennett was born and raised in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, by a single mother. At 16 years old, he moved to West Virginia and then Nevada to play basketball. It was a smart choice because by his senior season, he was ranked as the number one forward and the number seven player overall in the country in 2012. He ultimately chose to attend UNLV, where he had an amazing season. He averaged 16 points per game, 37% from three, and was extremely efficient with a PER of 28.3. PER is a player's efficiency rating that basically measures their performance by every statistical category for every minute of the game. To put in comparison, the NBA average is 15, and the highest ever PER by Wilt Chamberlain was 31, so it's safe to say that 28.3 was pretty great. With these great stats, Anthony Bennett declared for the 2013 NBA draft. He was predicted to be taken with anywhere from the 5th to the 11th pick in the draft, so it was a shock to everyone, including himself, when he was taken with the first overall pick in the 2013 NBA draft by the Cleveland Cavaliers. Bennett has said that he had no idea until his name was called that he'd be the first pick in the draft. Nerlens Noel was the one who was expected to go first overall, but he didn't get picked up until the 6th pick, with a large part of it being because he had a knee injury, causing him to miss the entire 2013 season. There also wasn't too many outstanding choices to pick from in the 2013 draft. The best player from the draft was Giannis Antetokounmpo, who was picked 15th, and CJ McCollum, who was picked 10th, and not many players before them having made a big impact in the league yet. Anthony Bennett played a good combination of an outside and inside game, and he had the stats to show for it. If he could continue to develop that game that he displayed in college, picking Anthony Bennett would have made sense for the Cavs. But an unnamed scout has said that UNLV's staff has a reputation for making people sound better than they are, so he feels UNLV didn't tell the Cavs about his poor work ethic and bad attitude at times. Anthony Bennett was drafted with an injury, so he also missed the summer league of his rookie season. He started the season out of shape and was often seen as being lazy and giving up on plays. It took him 5 games to score his first career NBA basket. While over 60% of all of the previous first overall picks scored double digits in their first game. In the offseason, he participated in the Cavs Summer League, where they weren't impressed. So that, along with the fact that LeBron James just joined the team, he was involved in a 3-way trade that saw him headed to the Timberwolves. He increased his points per game from 4 points a game to 5 points a game since the trade, but was let go after the season. He'd signed with the Raptors and would display some disappointing play there as well. They'd let him go because they didn't believe he cared for the game of basketball and didn't display much effort into training or the actual games. He signed with the Nets for the 2016 and 17 season and made it halfway through the season before being waived once again. This was the last time the former number one overall pick was seen on an NBA court. So where is he now? After being released by 3 NBA teams at only 23 years old, the next thing you'd expect a player like him to do is play overseas, develop your game, and show NBA teams how good you are, right? Wrong. Bennett played the first part of that right and signed with the Turkish Basketball Super League, and his team won the EuroLeague Championship, but he played even worse than he did in the NBA, and only averaged 1 point per game, shot 18% from 3, and was released on May 25th, 2017. He's been playing like he just hit 40, and his skills are declining every year. But now he's only 24, his stats should be going the other way. It's very clear that Anthony Bennett is the biggest bust in NBA history. But it's not really his fault. He didn't ask to be taken with the first overall pick, with all the pressures that go along with that. People have expected him to play like a first pick, when he was really supposed to be taken much further down the line. No news has come out of Anthony Bennett about his future since leaving his overseas team, but if I was him, I'd pull a Hassan Whiteside, get to the YMCA, play some pickup games for a start, then find my work ethic back, and then head on a path for the D-League. But with the performance that he's put out there, no team is gonna want him as is, so he's gonna need a lot of work and training before even any D-League team will consider him. Judging by what other NBA teams have said about his work ethic, it'll be up to him whether or not he really wants to play in the NBA or not. And we'll see what happens moving forward.